Hey, this is Mark Sims again. Just asking a few questions. Just asking a few questions. I have Marcia Logan on the line from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And we're going to talk about black women and black men. So, that's a favorite subject for some people. You know that? It really is. Yes. What's up, Marcia? What's going on?
Hey, how you doing?
Are you ready to talk about black men?
I am.
No, I was reading a Pew study, a Pew research. I forget who's the Pew people, but they do these researches and stuff. This is a 2017 study, and they said about interracial marriage, and they said 25% of black men marry outside the race, and about 12% of black women who marry outside the race. I'm not saying it's good and bad, but I'm going to ask you, Marcia Logan from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, why do 25% of black men marry outside the race?
Because they have no respect for their black mamas, I guess. You know, to me, you marry that which you deify. And the woman who raised you, raised you, sacrificed for you, loved you unconditionally, is who you deify when you pick a wife. That is who you tell the world you honor and cherish above all else. And I guess 25% of black men just didn't like their mamas.
That's kind of cold, you know that. Because see, you some people just fall in love. They may love their mother.
I don't believe that. What are you, three? You're a grown person. You know where we live. And I'm gonna be honest with you. At 18, I did date outside of my race. This gentleman who happened to be not black. And I knew even then, that was puppy love, and we were all, you know, he was a good guy and respectful and all that. But I knew at the door it wasn't going to go very far because I didn't want to bring children into this crazy earth. You know, I remember George Jefferson. I'm quoting George Jefferson. But he said he didn't believe in race mixing because all you get are mixed nuts. And I didn't want to bring a child into this world, you know, because all the love in the world is not going to help all the nonsense these children are going to have to go through. I think if you bring mixed children into this world, you're being just selfish. You're not thinking about them. You're not thinking about what they have to tolerate. Look, it's hard enough being black in this world. You throw in some other mixed race and some other stuff, and now you've got, you know, who am I going to, you know, am I going to love my mom? Do I love my dad? Half of my ancestry kidnapped my other half. And, you know, I just think it's unnecessary. And it's very selfish to make a child deal with all that because we don't live in a perfect world. We live in a very hate-filled world. And if you want to deal in reality, you know, it's hard enough bringing a child in that's marginalized at birth, but then you throw in some other stuff. And it just makes it very difficult, unnecessarily so. And that's why I don't buy that bull about you can't help who you fall in love with. What are you, three? It's not all about you. It's about what you're going to, if you're marrying for the sole purpose to, you know, people forget marriage is about bringing children. It's about legitimizing children. That is what it's about. And I don't know what it's turned into, but that's what it used to be about. It's a contract that allows for you to legally or legitimately have families. And I'm not getting into what that means to other people. I don't really care. But that is what a marriage contract is. So if you're going to think about these children and what they're going to have to tolerate, all your love in the world inside your bedroom is not going to protect them. So why would you bring innocent children into that kind of mess because you love this person? Get over it. Get over it. You're not three. You're a grown adult. No, and yet, and you know the consequence of it. And people, I'm not going to let anybody justify. I'm like, well, okay, well, when you get jumped and when your child has to be chased home or whatever, because this is the world in which we live. We don't live in your head. We don't live in your bedroom.
Marcia, you know, you have to remember that you're from a bygone era. You were born in the 1960s.
Yep, exactly.
And you're guess old what? School.
Look, we just had this weekend these, what do you call them, proper boys or proud boys, whatever you are, whatever they are, this hate-filled group. Downtown Philadelphia just 2 days ago, who went to someone's house for the sole purpose of beating this person up because they didn't look like them. So don't talk about 1960. We're back to 1960. Matter of fact, we're worse than 1960 because at least back then they weren't so blatant. They wore sheets. They snuck and did it. Now these fools think there's something great about hate. They think there's something great about bullying, even though they talk that crap differently when it comes to their front door. But these grown men went seeking out someone they didn't know for the sole purpose of beating them up. You see, cops are killing black boys left and right for all kinds of stupidity. So let's deal in reality. No, it's not 1960 in terms of chronology, but it is most certainly 1960 in terms of activity. Okay. We can't pretend like we live in a wonderful world. We don't. We live in a hate-filled world in which you have to worry about your children every step of the way. Look, I'm a mother of two black boys. There's not a day, a night that goes by that I don't worry about their safety. And now, there are no rules for that. They're killing black women, black children, all times of the day and night. You know, it just doesn't matter. Okay. My goodness, people, white folks are calling you because you're barbecuing. You're smiling.
We're gonna do a whole show on that.
I know. I'm just saying.
Modern day racism, bigotry. We're gonna do a whole another show on that. But okay, let's go back to this in this podcast about black women. Now, 12% of black women marry outside the race. What do you think of that, Marcia Logan?
I think they're insane. I think they are truly insane. You know, like I said, if you want to bring in all that nonsense, you want to bring in all that activity of, you know, hate that, because, like I said, you can't live inside of your little vacuum.
Yeah, but some people,
home.
You know, you meet people for a lot of different reasons why you fall in love with them.
And okay, are you grown or are you a child?
Yeah, but sometimes
you have
you can't,
to weigh the cost benefit.
You can't
of
pick.
That love.
Let's say you have a relationship, a marriage that you're not going to have children. You're not going to have children.
Okay. Well, then
and you fall in love with somebody who's not from your little tribe, your little race. Okay. Is that something wrong with that?
Well, I mean, no. If you want to stay in your bedroom, y'all only going to interact.
So your problem with interracial marriage.
Don't mind the consequence that comes with that.
I'm saying, okay. So your problem with interracial marriage is having children. When you have children, it becomes complicated. That's what you're talking
well,
about.
Well, no, my problem is that I see when I walk into my home, my castle, my domicile, I want to be at peace. I want to be laying with someone who gets me. And I don't care how much these people outside of these races say they love each other. You don't get each other. Okay? You don't.
But you, Marcia, that white person
is not going to ever know what it feels like for someone to call them the N-word.
I know, but you can connect with someone on a human level. Just see them as a human being.
What does that mean, a human level? So what, we can discuss peeing, and we can discuss what? What can we discuss? Anatomical conversations? I'm talking about, I went to work, and this white girl bumped up against me, called me the N-word, and I really wanted to kill her, and I knew if I did, nothing would happen to her, and I would get fired. No white person is going to understand that. They're going to be, oh, yeah, that was awful. Let's paint a sign and let's go. No, that's not what I want. I want my brother to just understand what I'm talking about without having to explain backdrop. And, you know, sometimes you just want to lay with somebody who gets you, who understands you, who feels you, without you having to, you know, lay on airs.
I understand, the
right time, the right place, I don't care how much you love each other. He's going to be calling her something out of her name, and she's going to be calling him something. You give each other the right circumstance. All this television, Hollywood love does not exist. It is something that was made up to sell clothes or to sell toothpaste or whatever. But when you live in the real world where you have to interact with real people and you have day-to-day affronts or what I used to like to call the black text, no white person understands that. And don't get me wrong, I have white friends who I adore, but I don't want to procreate with them. I don't want to necessarily, you know, tell them all my personal business.
You're a 9-to-5 integrationist, huh?
I guess so.
9-to-5, but
I guess I am a 9-to-5.
Maybe 12-hour integrationist.
I guess, because, you know, remember, I used to live in South Carolina, and look, you got along fine at work, but when you went home, pretty much the land down south is still pretty much segregated, and nobody's upset about that. You know what I mean? Because, you know, nobody's jumping you outside of your home. Nobody was telling you to go on the other side of the tracks or whatever. You know, because that's the world in which we live.
Now, Marcia,
people don't want to procreate, huh?
Now, Marcia, now, you know, I'm almost done. Got to wrap it up. But now you're not going to come back next week and say, Mark, listen, let me tell you something. What I said last week, I didn't fall in love with this white boy. He's so handsome.
That's never going to happen.
I'm in love now with the white boy. I'm sorry what I said last time on that show.
It's never going to happen. And plus, I like being black. I love having black children. I love that I have ancestors that fought hard for me to exist. Why would I want to water that down with something else? What is wrong with being proud of who you are? My pro-blackness is not anti anybody else. I love my black skin. I love being able to talk to my daughter about Queen Nzinga or Queen Makeda or Queen Ty. I mean, come on, Nefertari and, you know, Ramesses. Come on. Look at the rich history that we have that they don't teach our children in school. I love coming home and not having to water that down or temper it because it might be hurting somebody's feelings because they're of something different. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are and being proud of who you are. Because like I said, my pride and my Africanness has nothing to do with anyone else. It has to do with me and the legacy I want to leave for my children. The pride, the love, the respect that I want them to have for themselves and their people and their ancestry. There's nothing wrong with that. See, we've forgotten. There's nothing wrong with that. You come from a loving people. You come from the sun. You come from Ra. You come from such greatness. And it's wonderful to know that. See, our problem is we don't know that. We have forgotten it. We're so busy trying to please and be liked and please don't kill us. Please don't do this. No, I don't want that in my house. In my house, I want to be free to be me, to be loved the way I am in all my rich melaninness, for lack of a better term. And you can't do that once you start adding. But like I said, that has nothing to do with anybody else. It has to do with me and my children. And their pride, and their loving nature, which you have, and which and that's what you come from. See, we are believing the Willie Lynch stuff. We've bought into it. We really think we're criminals. We really think there's something wrong with us. That's why we try to escape it by joining in the others, and then we find out quite frequently and quickly that nobody else wants you like you. There's nothing like coming home and being home. And there's nothing wrong with it. See, that's what we've got to remind our children. There's nothing wrong with being proud of what you are. Don't buy the bullcrap.
I think a lot of people do agree with you, and there's some that don't, but we will talk about that next time. Once again, at the end of the show, it's been a pleasure. Marcia Logan from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Thanks for being on the show.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me.